वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग क्लिप भी मिल
जाएगा सर, वो पता कर लीजिएगा नंबर पे एक बार, अगर पॉसिबल पॉसिबल हुआ तो मिल जाएगा।
हाँ नहीं, इसमें ना एक कटर होता है सॉफ्टवेयर, वो कट करके उसमें क्लिप ले सकता है।
Gracias. Good morning, everybody. I know it's a Sunday, but the good morning has to be as good as a Sunday. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Wonderful. That looks good. Indeed, it's great. I mean, when you've left college and you start working and then you get back to those exams again, where we're just studying overnight, I think about 8 to 10 years back, I was one of you, 2009. So I really understand how difficult it is to see family, home, work, and then get the tappa that, you know, it's a good percentage and we've really done well with our exams. Indeed, I congratulate all of you. And the excitement of the husbands and the wives by the side, telling the bachas that your dad and mom also have done pretty well. That's indeed wonderful. We're just trying to put all of you to the respected places. And generally, this block is supposed to be with all the medal holders. So I'm calling in the names, and I hope you please have to get up or you have to move here, right? Yes? Thank you. Ye bhi bahut zaruri hai. Of the year 2018, and I'm going backwards like that. So we have the first name as Miss Anita Ahuja. Huh. Okay, we have Miss Anupma from Delhi. So I think you take the first seat, and now everybody would follow as I given the name. And then we have Miss Anita Ahuja. And then we have Mr. Sanjay Singh Mahar. We have Miss Neha Lal Pratap Singh. On seat number 4. Followed by Miss Shweta from Pune. Shweta Shelley. Then we have Miss Neha Sarswat from Delhi. And we have Mr. Shashi Kumar from Gurgaon. So I think we have 7. And we have Ms. Geetanjali Wheeler from Navi Mumbai. So now we have Ms. Rani Sharma from Jaipur on seat number 3. We have Ms. Himanshi from Delhi on seat number 4. Acha nahi hai? Okay. We have Mr. Ponkarthike from Chennai. He's not there. Okay. Ms. Arpita Chaudhary from Kolkata. Ms. Ruchita Deepak Chand. Mr. R. Tamil from Chennai. Hey, Ruchita is there. Mr. R. Tamil, नहीं है ओके मिस रीमा शर्मा देन द थर्ड रो वी हैव मिस रितु फ्रॉम मुंबई थर्ड रो फर्स्ट सीट रितु ओके And then we get to Ms. Gargi from Kolkata. Are you there? No? Ms. Madhura from Bangalore. Mr. Umesh from Navi Mumbai. Okay. So the next one is also Mr. Umesh, so he has a right to sit on two seats now. Okay. We have Miss Smita from Delhi. So is it a repetition? Okay. Mr. Shashi Kumar from Gurgaon. Achha, he's already there. Okay. Miss Rani Sharma from Jaipur, already there. Miss Anupma Chaudhary. Miss Anupma, are you there? No. Mr. Amay Kumar from Mumbai. No? No, no. He's Mr. Umesh. Okay. We have Mr. Shashi Kumar. You're already there. Okay. Ms. Shreya Jain from Delhi. Oh, please come. So you have seat number three. Ms. Caroline. Jacob. Okay. Mrs. Tejaswini from Bangalore. Are you there? Ms. Pooja from Pune. And Ms. Shreya is already there. So, yeah, fine. Okay. Gargi is not here, okay, and then Mr. Ameya Kumar Deshpande, not here, and Mrs. Tejaswini, not here, okay.
నరేష్ కుమార్ గారు ఐ వాంట్ టు టాక్ అబౌట్ యు మిస్టర్ నటరాజ్ రెడ్డి ఇస్ ది చైర్మన్ ఆఫ్ ది థాంక్స్ ఫర్ కమింగ్ సర్
ట్రాఫిక్ వాస్ వెరీ లెస్
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Chairman, Diploma Board, and we have Dr. Senthi Vadivel, who's National Treasurer. So I welcome all the esteemed guests and honorable dignitaries on the dais, and I welcome all the proud participants to the conversation.
I would just request all the dignitaries on the dais to please stand and light up the diya, that is invoking Goddess Saraswati, the goddess of education and belief,
so that she stays with us and be with us today for this procession and always.
Sir, ek saath mein rukho. Please, sir.
Vagadishwari Sharade
This is indeed our Indian ritual. There is some energy and some power that comes in with the blessings of God always. As we move ahead, I would just request our dear chairman to please present a bouquet to our esteemed chief guest, and we welcome you once again, sir. So I request Dr. Nadraj to please present a bouquet to former Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra. Thank you very much, sir, for taking out time and being the motivation for all of us. I would request our chairman, ISTD Diploma, Mr. Naresh Kumar, to please present a bouquet to our national president, Dr. Nataraj, and welcome him on board. Thank you, sir, for guiding us through and taking us forward always. And I request the chairman once again to present a bouquet to the national treasurer, Dr. Senthi Wadhwell. And of course, now it's for our chairman to get his share, and I request Dr. Nataraj to please welcome Mr. Naresh Kumar, Chairman Diploma Board, who's being continuously persevering towards improvement and directions. Thank you. Now I would request Mr. Naresh Kumar Pinisati, Chairman Diploma Board, to declare the convocation open.
Good morning, everybody. So this is basically a formality I need to actually go through. Based on the powers conferred on me by the National President and the National Council of ISTD, in my capacity as the Chairman of the Diploma Board, I hereby declare the convocation open. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And I would now request, sir, to deliver the address. And before that, I would just like to give a brief about him, though he's been a very dominant and a strong person with ISTD for years. Mr. Naresh Kumar is a postgraduate in HR from NIIPM with an executive MBA from Scandinavian International Management Institute. Sir is currently associated with Deepak Fertilizers and Petrochemicals Corporation Limited as Group President Corporate Governance. And with that kind of load and pressure, we always get him here for all the requirements that we have. Prior to this, he was associated with Vestas as Director and Regional Head of HR for Asia Pacific Region. He was also associated with multinational Bayer Group in India as General Manager HR and Nagarjuna Fertilizers Limited. He's widely traveled across Europe and Asia Pacific and is exposed to the latest international concepts in people management. He's a certified coach and he's a certified mentor and guide for all of us. Over to you, sir.
Thank you for that introduction. So I'll start with a welcome note. In fact, there is some wall between me. I think people are unable to see me also because of the dais here. So dignitaries on the dais, our chief guest, Honorable Justice Deepak Mishra ji, all the colleagues of ISTD, and those who have come here to receive the diploma certificates today, and the ladies and gentlemen. So I take this opportunity to extend a warm welcome to you to this convocation 2019. And it's indeed my pleasure to be here with all of you and sharing the joy. I know how joyful it will be for those people who already received their degrees earlier. Now it's a second time in their life they're actually receiving, attending a convocation and receiving another certification. So congratulations to all of you who have passed out successfully in this diploma examination. I know most of you are working actually, and I know how difficult it is to work and also pursue higher education. So you need more accolades than anyone else because of the pursuit you have undertaken, the hard work you've been put into, and also the ability to actually balance between the work life, the family, and also the academic pursuit. So a little bit about our chief guest, Honorable Justice Deepak Mishraji here. So when we approached him, in fact, he has readily accepted our invitation to be amongst the all of us here, because he has a penchant for education and he would love to work towards promoting education in a country like India. So you all know he was still recently presiding over as the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of India. And we've been privy to some path-breaking judgments. In fact, one of the judgments you all must be still debating upon is the annulling of Section 377. It's actually the restoring the rights and the freedom of the LGBT community. You all must have heard about this judgment and read it also, because it featured on the front pages of all newspapers. The other judgments that we'll have to look at is, this judgment actually has set aside a 157-year-old outdated law of a colonial era. So that's one of the path-breaking judgments coming from the Honorable Chief Justice. And we have other judgments like upholding the validity of the Aadhaar. Then you have the national anthem, which is being debated upon, whether people should stand while the national anthem is being played. You must have heard about that judgment also, how we need to uphold the nationality and also respect our national anthem. Then you have some other judgments coming through, like that defamation law should remain on the books of the jurisprudence. Then also he went on to give this judgment in terms of permitting the entry of women into certain temples, which till that time was a taboo actually. So the most, I would say, interesting judgment, which we still have memories of, is the midnight hearing he has given to some of the lawyers who filed a petition to stay the execution of Yakub Miman, who was an accused in the Bombay blast case. So you must have known it. He has got many, many, many achievements, and I would say the path-breaking judgments to his credit, but we don't have so much of time to delve upon that. And in fact, when he was laying down the office, he spoke about the voice of the youth. He said the youth, voice of the youth is more important than air, maybe because we are the youngest country on the planet today. We have, because most of these countries are aging very fast, but we still have the demographic dividend as well as being the youngest nation. So he went on to add, I'm young, I belong to this generation. Certainly, sir, we, after having gone through your judgments, we acknowledge that. So he can think young and act young. So he is the right person to be among us today. And in fact, a little bit about the training diploma you all have, you're going to have in your hands today, a little bit about the diploma also. You know, India is actually poised to emerge as the second largest economy by 2030. as per the predictions of many, many. You look at Accenture or Standard Chartered. So we will be next only to China. So what does that mean? What is that we'll have to do? It doesn't happen just like that. We need to train at least 100 million people by 2030. And that means every year we need to train 10 million people. So on the other hand, the way we work is changing. We are talking about artificial intelligence, machine learning, automation happening, that machines will take away our jobs. We are talking a lot of things. We are reading a lot of things about this. So this is an opportunity to the training professionals, according to me, because you have that many more people to train. Today we are able to train 3 million people in a year, and we need to scale it up to 10 million people. So in a VUCA world, what exactly are the skills which are needed if man is working along with machines tomorrow? It already started, actually. You look at Alexa, Siri, and all that. So I think it's become a part of our life for us. So attitudinal training will be very important, because the old adage is you hire for attitude and train for skills. If a person is having the right attitude, it's easy for him to be trained in any skill, because skills are going to redundant very fast, unlike the olden days. Maybe when I've entered employment, I don't know anything about a computer. How do you work on a computer? What is an email? We don't know anything, but we have learned. We have skilled ourselves, and then we have grown with the time. So, but then the skill redundancy is going to be very fast. So the future will be actually skilling, reskilling, and upskilling. So that's a great opportunity for all of us sitting here in this room. And the fortunate thing is the government and the organizations are willing to spend top dollar on training. That's a good thing for us, because they also realized that the only competitive edge for them is to stay ahead of the competition is to continuously skill their people. The third mega trend which we need to look at is this training is now moving away from classrooms. You all must be aware today, especially the Gen Y, whose attention span is so limited. So you can't give them a lecture for one full day in a training classroom. So you have web-based learning, people learning at their own pace, at their own time. Then we are also talking about bite-sized learning. Many universities have opened up their doors actually for the training over web actually. So with this, I don't have much time to go on like this. So thank you so much, and welcome you all once again for this wonderful event today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for briefing us on how it has to be and how we've been taking it forward. And now I would just request Dr. Natraj Ray, our national president, to deliver his presidential address. A brief about Sir, who's a graduate in science and holds an array of professional qualifications in terms of diplomas and certifications relating to industrial relations, personal management, an MBA in HR, an LLB, a PhD, just to name a few. So that is his wide variety that places him with a deep understanding and insight that is required. He's a life member of ISTD and has taken over the position of national president in May 2019. Prior to his election to this position,